let's quickly kind of show you how you can turn this into a full-blown chat. So so now this is a another function app, but it's got the same negotiate endpoints, nothing special there. I think that even the send message is about the same. It does a little bit more because this is running in static web apps, and it's actually going to parse the headers to figure out who the actual caller is, the user detail, so they can't spoof that. Like they're logged in. So I'm pulling out the user detail, and I'm actually setting that as their sender. So basically setting the sender to that username. So so you're securely sending these messages. So when you see the server saying this message came from Anthony, it really did come from Anthony. But aside from that, it's really kind of the same thing. Like this is the, remember the target and arguments thing, doing exactly the same thing as before. And then there's actually one more thing that we're doing is that in my function.json, I am calling out, I have an output binding for table storage as well. Mm. So I'm saving these messages as well. And that's, that's done by this line of code. So basically this line of code and this line of code both saves a message to storage or to a table, as well as broadcast that message everywhere. So it's really easy to use. And like I was talking about before, when you first connect, you need to get the message history. So I have an HTTP trigger table basically saying, give me the latest 50 messages. And then the code is literally one line of code. I'm just going to return all those messages back to the browser. So really, I think we looked at maybe 20, 30 lines of code in the server side. And that's going to be everything that you need for this app to run. And then I'll show you the HTML as well. This is using Vue. So just a lot of HTML stuff. But really down here, you'll recognize the connection stuff. You'll recognize me setting up a listener for the new message. Which is now just a post to the server, so I'm posting my endpoint. Get authenticated users, don't worry about that. Load messages history, so when you first start up, we're going to make a get to the messages endpoint. That's going to return messages on the table. And that's really all it is. Like, it's just a standard view app. And then if I go to, I think it's like chat.anthonychu.com, it might already be logged in, but say I'm logged in, so let me log out.
Now, that static web app logout that you're using, is that something that's built into static web apps, or you like using the Graph toolkit?
No, this is actually completely from static web apps. So I didn't really have to do anything. When I click this button, I'm actually literally just redirecting to the login kind of like endpoint for static web apps.
Okay.
And because I'm already logged into GitHub, it's going to bounce me right back. So you can see that I'm logged in. I tested this 4 months ago. Hope it still works. Testing. And you can see it worked, if I kind of copy this and open up a new browser, paste that in, come back over here, say hi, you can see that both browsers get it, right? So really easy to do, and it works. So that's how you kind of would kind of build a real world app with it. It's fairly straightforward to have to kind of deploy this to the static web apps.
Okay, and so then I could go and like sign in with my GitHub. Of course, I'm going to need to MFA real quick here. Chugga. Boop. And
all right, I'm excited. I'm waiting.
I'm going to authorize it. Grant consent. Anthony now owns half of everything that is mine.
Hey, it worked.
There it is. Very cool.
Nice. That is awesome. I wasn't sure if that was going to work. I don't know why. Maybe it's because I wrote it, so who knows what's going to happen.
I had full faith in you.